I am Mo Tuzano, the tabletop bellhop, your cardboard concierge, working with you to make your game nights better by doing things like showing you what you get in the box with this. This is a new expansion for Chronicles of Avel from Rebel Studios. Now, I do have to thank Rebel Studios for sending me a review copy of this, as well as a while back the base game. Now, Chronicles of Avel is a cooperative, kids family weight, tower defense, cooperative board game that features an awesome equipment system with a dual layer board where you reach in the bag and pull out your treasure, and you can kind of feel around trying to find the right shape treasure for what you're missing. It also features something my kids loved, character sheets you can color. Now check out my Chronicles of Avel review for more information on that and why you should be excited about that game. And now even more excited now that this expansion is out. This is a huge expansion, adding four new game modes to the game. So I don't know if it's still tower defense, but you have four new ways to play, including transports. There's also blank tokens to create your own mini expansion. So my kids are going to love this, right? My daughter's going to be able to sit there and make her own equipment for her character. This is a full campaign called the Shards of Evil campaign. You've defeated the Beast of the Black Moon, but there's more things. The evil did not lay down. This looks really cool. Big fan of the original game. Looking forward to showing this off. Now, no, I have not played this expansion. I have actually never seen any more than this box in the shrink wrap. I have not seen what's inside. So you're going to get to discover that with me. Step one for that, though, is going to be cutting the shrink. So we're going to start with that. So here you have the box for Chronicles of Avel New Adventures expansion. Note, you do need to own Chronicles of Avel to use this. I'm going to show off the sides really quick. And one of the best things in Avel is the artwork. They're really evocative, and it's a very different take on fantasy. One of my kids' favorite parts of playing the original game was reading up the monster descriptions, because they didn't fit what you expected. Note, this does not add additional players. It is still a four-player cooperative game. All right, inside the box, there we have, right off the front, additional game modes and scenarios. Look at that. That is not... Oh, I have multiple things here. So, what do we have here? Chronicles of Avel New Adventures Prologue. And then we have a player's aid. And then we have all kind... What is going on here? All right, let's jump back to this quickly. Game modes and scenarios. So this gives you an introduction. It looks just as well done as the original for the various different factions. Components used in gameplay with the moon monster, new setups, all kinds of different interesting rules here. Looks like there's some interesting, like, two-part creatures that is new to the game. Showing the different dice effects. I know, again, I haven't played this, so you're getting to see this the same time I have. I do like the way these slot in. That looks really cool. We have, it looks like, new types of the equipment you can find. New token sets. So there's different components used in different game modes. So the Oberon is a character you can go and trade with who actually holds on to tokens, which looks really neat. The Titans game mode. There is a lot going on here. Like this looks like it's like five times more gameplay than the original here. Components used in the Cruel Hunters game mode. Shards of Evil campaign. Look, there's like a frog thing. Check out the 3D frog thing. Okay, I don't think I'm going to assemble anything today, but oh, there's a 3D cart. Okay, some really cool looking stuff. 3D spiders. More castle walls. Rulebook looks neat. Look at this thing. Some kind of funky dial. Oh, some new map setups. That's always appreciated. End of the game. Well, even more. Look at all the map setups. Wow. Okay, so what's this? This is a prologue. Okay, this is story. There was fiction in the original game. So this is just the prologue story. There's a story and then some type of campaign. So there's a campaign in here with a new bestiary. Then there's a player aid explaining all these different new components and things. Nice. That's a nice thick card for a player aid. The various different tokens. Man, there's a lot of stuff. How to assemble all this funky new bits. Look at all the 3D stuff that's going to be in here. Okay, I didn't see anything about. Is this like part of the box? Nowhere here explained what this is. Wow. Kind of baffled by all this stuff. Look at it all. All right. Worst unboxing ever because I didn't watch someone else unbox it first, so I don't even know what some of these components are. All right. My bad. I guess I should have did some research on this one before we started. I don't see anything about how to build whatever this is. Or even what that is. Okay. So here's the like neat compass piece. It requires a grommet and stuff, but like check that out. This piece is going to come out. You can kind of see through it. And this is going to attach up top over here. So this bends up and you actually like build this thing. So you get this like cool compass thing, but then there's a dial that has to be attached inside, which isn't part of these. So there's three of these. So that's cool. Nice thick card. These fold really nice. Like it's got the pre-cut on the one side for 3D components. That's really nice. These are the sheets for making your own magic items. Expand your world by bringing new monsters to life. It says new monsters, but these are the, oh, there's monsters too. Okay, cool. They even have the different backs. So I was hoping to just get one of these, but there you go. Tokens. So that, you know, you can draw your own stuff and they do have the backside here with the generic tokens. So cool. Oh, look at all this cardboard. A lot of cardboard. Oh, and it's punching itself. Look at the 3D dinosaur monster things. Jeez. This is the multi-headed thing once you build it. Again, I'm not going to build the stuff here. Here's the cart. And the weird 3D frog. More parts of the various monsters. Holy cow. There's a lot of stuff in this. New monsters, those I recognize. How to defeat them, the number of dice they attack with. Here's the dials for those boards. There is more cardboard in this than the original. I'm almost certain. More parts of the frog, the frog faces. Pretty cool. Timing pieces. The flipping box inserts a dungeon. All the different moon pieces to put together. Which I thought that was cool, that there's different colors here. Wow. Okay, so some of this is box insert. I just don't quite get how this folds to make a box insert. All right, grommets for putting together things, baggies. Oh, these are cool. Little plastic half pieces. Or are they metal? No, they're plastic. Look at those. Kind of metallic. I'm trying to figure out, so this came with this, and I don't know what for, like what this is. This has a definite fold here and here, or fold all the way over, and I don't. Want to damage anything here, but I think it's supposed to be part of a box insert. Yes, okay. All right. I figured out one part of my own. So this literally goes here so you can open it up, which means this somehow has to go on this one. And I think it's going to split like this. Yes. There, I figured it out on my own. I am S-M-R-T. Oh, backwards. I'm not so smart. All right, there you go. Now we know what those pieces are for. All right. Rebel Studios, if you're listening, put something in here that tells me what all these bits are for. So now I don't know what's supposed to go where. We're just going to put stuff in where it fits. And I probably shouldn't have done that until all this was punched. Because now it's probably not going to fit. Yeah, see? Okay. Well, now I understand why they did it. Because now I can't fit all this back in the box. So we are going to take that back apart just so I can fit everything back in. Look at all these new components. You got three-headed monsters. You got weird jumpy frogs. What's not in here is any more hex tiles. There's a cart. More three-headed monster bits. I have no clue what this huge thing is. New ways to play Chronicles of Avel, the cooperative dice game bag. Not bag builder. Bag puller. You pull things. So this is where those plastic things actually slot See? They actually slot in there. Cool, eh? All right. Assembly instructions for all this stuff. This flipping piece that I had no clue what to do with. All right, there. Flat like that. There we go. So yes, how to assemble all that stuff. Ton of stuff. I apologize for not actually doing more research before opening this one up. I wasn't expecting so many different things in one box. Like, I don't even know if you start here or with this prologue, or is this go with this? Because there's a whole bunch of new game modes. But I gotta say, it all looks very cool. All right, there you have a somewhat fumbling look at Chronicles of Avel New Adventures expansion, an expansion for the Cooperative family weight tower defense board game from Rebel Studios, who again we have to thank for sending a review copy of this. This looks really cool. A ton of new 3D components, some nice plastic components, tons of cardboard in here. Ridiculous amount of cardboard for one box. A box insert that's actually also a castle dungeon that you can open up to store things. It is looking really neat. I am a big fan of Avel. Again, check out a review of Avel if you haven't already. And see why I'm excited about this. I can't wait to try this. My kids are going to love it. And one of the things my daughters are going to love the most is the fact there is customizable magic items, like the equipment items that you draw from the bag when you're playing. And they're going to love that. They're both aspiring artists who can draw pretty well. So it's going to look pretty cool. I'm looking forward to seeing what they create to add to our game. Plus a whole campaign. So that looks pretty sweet. Rebel Studios blowing it out of the park for the artwork, the background, the story, and now like nice, cool 3D cardboard components adding to the game. Just like the first expansion added catapults that were or trebuchets. It's one of the ballistas. It was ballistas. That's what it was. Ballistas, 3D ballistas. Now you got all kinds of 3D things, including like a multi-headed Hydra thing in all three colors. Really looking forward to checking this out. Thank you, Rebel Studios. Once I do start playing this, I will be sharing my thoughts on social media, where you can find me everywhere as Tabletop Bellhop, one word. I'll probably be doing up a review at some point over at tabletopbellhop.com, and we will be talking about this on the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, which you can find on your podcatcher of choice. Thank you for joining me for this unboxing of Chronicles of Avel New Adventures Expansion.